morning students, myself Dr. Chandrasekhar N, working as Professor in the Department of Chemistry and Dean Academics, Sridevi Institute of Engineering and Technology, Tumkuru. Today I am going to explain the determination of viscosity coefficient of a given organic liquid using Ostwald's viscometer. For determining viscosity coefficient of a given organic liquid, we need viscometer. This is Ostwald's viscometer, and you need a timer for noting down the number of seconds taken by the liquid to move from two fixed points. Then an organic liquid whose viscosity is to be determined, and distilled water, we are going to determine the relative viscosity with respect to water. Then acetone for drying the viscometer, and an air dryer, hot air dryer, for drying the viscometer. So these are the requirements for determining viscosity coefficient of a given organic liquid. So this viscometer contains two limbs. One is narrow limb and another is wider limb. And two bulbs are there, one small bulb and another large bulb. First we have to take the liquid into the large bulb. Then this smaller bulb has two fixed marks, above the bulb one mark and below the bulb one mark. Two fixed points are there, you can see, above the bulb one mark and below the bulb one mark. Now for determining viscosity, first you have to take a dried viscometer. Otherwise you have to dry the viscometer by rinsing with acetone and drying with hot air oven. Now I am taking a dried viscometer. It is completely clean. Now I have to take a known volume of the given organic liquid. You can pipette it out, either say a fixed volume, say 20 cm cube of the liquid into the wider limb, or you can take up to the neck of the wider limb. So I will take up to the neck of the wider limb. I will transfer the given organic liquid slowly into the wider limb. See, I am transferring slowly the liquid to the wider limb. See, I have taken the liquid up to the neck of the wider limb. Now I have to send this liquid to the smaller bulb, either by pushing the liquid air from this wider limb or sucking the liquid from this end. For sucking, use a rubber tube. Fix the rubber tube to the narrow limb and fix the viscometer to a stand. Now slowly suck the liquid such that this liquid must reach above this upper mark. Now you can see the liquid level is above the upper mark. When liquid again flows back, when the lower meniscus of the liquid reaches the upper mark, you have to start the stop clock. So this is the button for starting the stopwatch. Then same button can be used for stopping the stopwatch, and this button you can use it for resetting to zero. So it has two buttons, one is start stop button and reset button. So you have to start the stopwatch when the lower meniscus of the liquid reaches the upper mark. You have to stop the stopwatch when the lower meniscus of the liquid reaches to the lower mark. Means you are recording the number of seconds time taken by the liquid to move from these two fixed points through a narrow capillary tube. Here there is a narrow capillary tube. The liquid flows through the narrow capillary tube. So I will suck little more liquid such that the liquid must come above the mark. Then I leave the liquid freely. Liquid flow down. As it starts flows down, I will start the stopwatch when it reaches to the upper mark. Now you see the liquid is flowing down. I have to stop the stopwatch when the liquid reaches to the lower mark. Yes. Now the time taken by the liquid to move from this mark to this mark is 3 minutes 8 seconds. 3 minutes means 180 seconds, 60 into 3, and 8 seconds, 188 seconds. I have to record in the manual. So this is the tabular column. You have to prepare tabular column. Trial 1, trial 2, trial 3. TW means time flow of water. TL, time for liquid flow. So now I have to write down here 188 seconds. You have to record time in 188 seconds. Then same way you have to repeat another 3 trials. You have to do it for liquid. Again I have to suck the liquid, and again I have to take trial 2. Then I have to record the time taken by the liquid to flow between two fixed points through the capillary. Then another trial also with the same liquid I have to do. Total 3 trials you have to take. Then average of those 3 trials we have to take. So 3 trials and divided by 3 will give you average time flow of the for the liquid to travel from two fixed points through the narrow capillary tube. Now after that, after 3 trials, pour back the liquid to the beaker given to you. Then you have to use the same viscometer for measuring time flow for the water. Before that, now the viscometer is contaminated with the organic liquid. The viscometer contains organic liquid. So you have to remove this organic liquid, and for removing this organic liquid you have to add acetone into the viscometer. Take few drops of acetone, concentrated acetone, transfer using pillar, rinse all the surface inside of the viscometer with the acetone, both the limbs. Now remove the used acetone to another beaker. Now the viscometer is rinsed with acetone, which is a volatile liquid. Now just by blowing hot air, we can remove the acetone vapors from the viscometer. And why we are using acetone? Acetone is a solvent which has capacity to dissolve most of the organic liquids. That's why we are using acetone. And acetone is a volatile liquid. By heating the viscometer, easily we can remove the acetone vapors from inside. Now I am using hot air dryer for drying the viscometer. Now the viscometer is completely dried. After that, now you have to cool the viscometer to the room temperature. Okay. When the viscometer is hot, you should not carry out for the testing time flow for the water. After viscometer cooling completely, then you have to transfer again same quantity of water to the wider lane. After transferring distilled water to up to the neck of the wider limb big bulb, we have to take up to the neck of the big bulb. Then fix the viscometer to the stand. Then use the rubber tube, fix the rubber tube for sucking the water. You suck the water from the big bulb to a small bulb. Then measure the time taken by the water to move between these two fixed points. So for water also, you have to carry out 3 trials and you have to take average of 3 trials. Now, calculation part. So you can see here, the calculation part. We have time taken by the water is 116 seconds, trial 2 118 seconds, trial 3 119 seconds, average time is 117.66 seconds. Time taken by the liquid to flow is first trial 188 seconds, you have seen. Second trial 189 seconds. Third trial 190 seconds. Average is 189 seconds. Then you have to record the laboratory temperature because viscosity of liquids dependent on the temperature. So that's why the laboratory temperature of today's lab is 25 degree Celsius. Now we have the formula for calculating viscosity. Viscosity of liquid divided by viscosity of water is equal to time taken by the liquid TL into DL, density of the liquid, divided by viscosity of water. Then this is time taken by the water and density of water. So we have to determine viscosity of liquid is equal to TL into DL into NW divided by TW into DW. The units for viscosity is millipoise. So NW, viscosity coefficient of water, will be given to you, that is 8.937 millipoise at 25 degree Celsius. Density of water at 25 degree Celsius is 0.9970 grams per cc. Density of given liquid also will be provided by us, 1.1978 grams per cc at 25 degree Celsius. Now, substituting the values, you will get the viscosity of the liquid as 17.24 millipoise. Now, you have to record the result of this one. The viscosity coefficient of the given liquid is 17.24 millipoise. So, this is how you can determine viscosity coefficient of any given liquid by using Ostwald's viscometer. For more experiments, you log on to our website www.shridevengineering.org, or you can subscribe to get more number of experiments. Thank you.